Welcome to Pyramid Times. Myself, Veena Subbu, VP at Pyramid Times, and we have with us an amazing guest, Dr. Hari Prasad. Dr. Hari Prasad is a pediatric surgeon at Anantapur, Andhra Pradesh, India, and he is also a heartfulness meditation trainer, spreading this beautiful technique and wisdom to one and all. He also has an ABBA TV YouTube channel, which is very hilarious, through which he will get everybody to the present moment and see the beauty of this our own lives. With this, I welcome Dr. Hari Prasad, sir, to Pyramid Times. Welcome, sir.
Yeah, welcome.
And today, our topic is on heartfulness meditation. We would like to hear from you, your journey in heartfulness meditation.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. I am Dr. Hari Prasad, pediatric surgeon from Anantapur. And I am running my own clinic. And I'm having a very busy practice also. But luckily, I entered into the spirituality at the age of 26 for the meaning of life and also to realize what I am, actually what I am. Am I a physical body? Am I a thought? Or am I existence? Or am I the creator? Who am I? That's what I wanted to know by the age of 26. There were so many circumstances which forced me to think like that, to reset like that, to go ahead like that. So in that reset, I have entered into the spirituality through Ramchandra Mission, which is now named as Heartfulness. Through Ramchandra Mission, when I took the first sitting through a preceptor, that means a heartfulness trainer, when I took first sitting, that was a great and profound experience. When I crossed, my consciousness crossed from my physical level to the mental level to beyond that which is not explainable. The first day itself, I had such experience. That experience made me to be motivated to be a perfect Abhyasi. Not perfect, Abhyasiya. And also a perfect thinker, analyzer, so many things. It motivated in the first thing itself. From the first day, I was trying to meditate every day without rest. For at least 2 to 3 hours a day, I will spend my time with meditation fast and all. I read less, but I do more. So through that experiences, through the life circumstances, in combination with those two, I could realize so many things. I could apply the spiritual techniques in my life, in my spiritual practice, and also in my medical practice, in my surgical practice. In so many ways, I could apply those techniques from the heart, those teachings from the heart, to be moralized, to be one and same in and out. Like that, so many things I have realized and I'm going through. Till now I have realized only 0.5% it seems. Till 99.5% is there. Now my age is 45. My spiritual journey was almost 19 years till now.
That's very amazing, sir. I think doctors have that natural inclination of openness. That heart compassion is always radiating, treating the patients and giving that confidence that they could get better. That is very amazing. Yeah. So what exactly is heartfulness meditation, sir?
So what exactly heartfulness meditation? So heartfulness meditation, any meditation means nothing but focusing the mind, practicing the focusing the mind, not meditate. So meditative state is different. Practicing meditation is different. Practicing meditation means you are trying to learning the focus of mind. So you are still learning. So in that you are practicing. So the first day itself you cannot focus on it. And whatever thing you want to focus, you cannot focus. There will be so many obstacles. First thing is mind activity itself. That is a very vibrant energy. So that so many thoughts will get arise. So every day, every human being will get around 70,000 thoughts. Among them, we'll focus on 50 or 60 or 100. Among them, we'll do work on 10 or 15 thoughts. Among them, we'll succeed on only one or two. Remaining 69,900 is disturbance actually. So if you cut down the disturbance by practicing, by continuous practice, over a period of decades, you need to practice. Intelligent people will learn quickly. People like me, like a little bit slow learner, will take time to observe what is happening in the mind and also what are the factors that are influencing the instability in the mind. So those things we have to know. That comes only through the practice. if you are not practicing and if you are trying to preach, it is not possible. So heartfulness meditation, here the essence comes. What is that essence? Pranahuti Shakti. That Pranahuti Shakti itself, yogic transmission. That yogic transmission will clear so many obstacles in your journey into your heart. So that energy comes from the source, that is from Guru. He is Dr. Kamlesh D. Patel. He is a guru of the heartfulness meditation. So from him, the transmission will be coming. And I am one of his channel, and I am authorized channel. So I am also transmitting. Like me, there are 13,000 heartfulness trainers working on the earth to enlighten the society with that energy. So that energy will pass from me into you, from Guru into you directly, from me into you directly. So that energy itself is the best, most wonderful essence in the heartfulness meditation. If you connect with a prayer, or else if you connect with a suggestion that Master is helping me, or else that God is helping me, immediately that power starts to work on you. Slowly over a period of time, that may be seconds, minutes, hours, general. So in that time, the transmission will make you experience the deeper things in your heart. So once you go and connect to the deeper things, and when you come out, you will be connected to this world and the deeper essence in your heart. Between those two, you have to adjust your lifestyle from the instability to the stability. So slowly you will learn, practice by practice of meditation, slowly you will learn, you will avoid unnecessary things, you will avoid so many unnecessary nuisances in your life, and you will be becoming so much perfect and stabilized and settled, and slowly going deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper, and you are becoming so powerful, so stabilized, so energetic, so enthusiastic, so creative. So many qualities will come with the heartfulness meditation that happens by the help of transmission, mostly by the help of transmission. Here, everything we will lose, our ego, our prejudices, our misunderstanding, so many things we will lose slowly, and we will becoming so much friendlier. This is what the real essence of heartfulness transmission meditation. So in that, yogic transmission is the main essence. Yeah.
That is very beautiful, sir. Connecting to this source or the guru, and which is our inner thing, yeah. Which we can connect to the outer world also in a very wonderful way.
Remembrance, the transmission works on outer world also. So in the remembrance of Guru, the transmission through the heart will be working on the nature also, surrounding people also. That is how it helps.
So have you been to any other meditation techniques, sir, before?
Till now, I have not completed the complete essence of heartfulness meditation. That's why I didn't touch any other system. But before entering into the Ramchandra mission, I was practicing Omkara meditation by my own and pyramid meditation with the help of Dr. Harikumar. But very few months I could practice, and at that time I was not much serious about those systems. And Omkara, when I was meditating on Omkara in the time of intermediate, around 91-92, I developed an intuition. So I'll be getting an intuition that some people are coming to me. They'll be coming definitely. So such type of intuitions they came. But once I started this heartfulness meditation, those things are cleared. I am now practical. So no intuition, only work. Yeah. I don't have much experiences about other systems. I am still practicing heartfulness meditation, not reached to the core.
So, how exactly is guru-disciple relationship in this particular meditation, sir?
Yeah, guru-disciple. Usually, student will search for perfect guru. But getting a perfect disciple also, very wonderful thing for guru also. So, both are coincidence. So, if he gets the best student, that is his luck. If he gets the best guru, that is his luck. So, that will be judged by the heart. How far this guru is helpful, how far this student is worthy. But a perfect guru, if he takes any subject, he'll transform them into his level at any cost. He can do that. That is what perfect guru is called. A student, with the help of guru, he will become a master. That is up to the, or more than to the level of master. So that's a wonderful relation. as of now, I am not a perfect student. So, I am still practicing to be a perfect student. Okay.
So there is still space for always expansion in this beautiful reality.
Yeah,
it is
yeah.
very wonderful, sir. And what is your vision of spreading this heartfulness meditation to the world?
My vision, it's not my vision, it is Guru's vision. Whatever he wanted to do, that will happen. So I am a preceptor. I am a channel. So I am trying to spread it to the every heart in this creation, every heart in this world. Because every heart must be activated. Every heart must get cleaned. Every heart must get purified. Every heart gets moralized. So this thing will take time, maybe centuries, but this will happen surely by the grace of Guru. So my motto is nothing but spreading heartfulness. Other than that, I don't have any work on that.
That is so amazing, sir. Focusing on one thing is important. Like Bruce Lee says, if we practice just one posture or whatever, then they will excel in that particular thing. That is so very nice in this particular time where people go on searching for peace and happiness everywhere.
Yeah.
Sticking to one thing is very beautiful. So before we move on to the practice of heartfulness meditation, I would like to speak about the intention or motive behind creating ABBA TV channel, sir.
Yeah, actually ABBA TV, I didn't create it. It happened naturally. So this ABBA TV, Telugu, all the Telugu people know that ABBA. There are so many links connected to the word ABBA. If they get hurted, I feel they feel ABBA. If they are feeling very much happy, ABBA. If they are so much excited, they will be calling ABBA. If they are wondering, if they are feeling pain, so many ways this ABBA word will come. So even the small kids, they'll start uttering the word ABBA. ABBA. So this ABBA TV happened very naturally without my knowledge. Just I named it. Now it is spreading across globe with the subscribers of 36,000. I didn't even imagine. In March, it was around 260 people. Now it is around 36,000. So this is how it is happening.
I do see this is also
it's
like...
It's happening. It's happening. That's all. Because it's happening.
Correct, sir. So I do see this as also like a meditation techniques. Maybe it could be laughter, yoga or whatever. Whenever I see your channel, I keep on seeing multiple videos and it's so hilarious. Yeah. We get into a particular zone where we are not connected to the worldly pain or suffering anymore. We land up in a very wonderful space and that is a very beautiful contribution, sir. So, can you also explain or take us through heartfulness meditation a little bit for our viewers, sir?
It's a heartfulness meditation. Now it is spreading across the globe. By the help of internet also, social media and internet, so many things are helping in spreading the heartfulness. And each and everyone can join this heartfulness through an app, Heart app. So HEARTSAPP, Heart app. And everyone can utilize this app for their spiritual services. And they are literally very much wonderful progress is happening. And we are not forcing anyone to join or we are not requesting. We are not doing anything for the abhyasis, but they are motivated by the surrounding circumstances and also by the mouth spread of, mouth publicity of regarding heartfulness meditation. That's happening naturally. And it is the grace of God. That's all. It is grace of God. Because one day I could feel the whole universe is one and same, that is nothing but God. He is the God of it. He is God in everything. He is a rapist and he is a raped. Both are is God in existence only, and it is happening by the will and grace of God. It happens like that. So when both are one and same of God, so if you reach that condition, you cannot feel the pain, you cannot feel the pleasure also. You cannot feel the pain, you cannot feel the pleasure also. You are in the state of sthita prajna. So such a wonderful state will arrive through the help of meditation, heartfulness meditation. So still I am waiting for that. Still, I didn't reach that condition, but it's a very wonderful condition I'm experiencing. They are still level. This is a really wonderful system.
And what are the benefits you have seen with people that come to you, sir?
Benefits in the sense they are getting relaxed immediately. Whatever pressure they carry in their heart, that will be cleared immediately and they'll feel relaxed. They'll be in the relaxed state when they are leaving my room. They are very much peaceful and they are very much happy, enlightened also. But very few people, they are working to progress in the meditation. They want to just come and relax and go. They don't want to research on it. So very few people, around one or two people only, they are still sticking to meditation and they are continuing their heartfulness practice. Remaining all people, they are coming and relaxing and going away. That's all. So in my view, your life has to make you to realize what you have to get. Because we are taking the life, which is a pre-programmed journey on the earth, which will make you to encounter so many situations. So I have encountered so many situations during my intermediate, in the negativity of the society. I have shock and stunned. After that, I didn't care about death. After that, when I was studying MBBS, I got a doubt, where am I in my body? After that, what is the purpose of this journey on the earth with the hardcore struggles and all? What is the purpose? Is it having any real purpose, or it is just happening like that? I could not realize. So what is the purpose, real purpose of journey on the earth? So those things will be stimulated by the life. So your life is your journey, and your life will stimulate you to that extent. Otherwise, you cannot be a Veena who is on spiritual path at the youngest stage. So myself, Hari Prasad, in the spiritual journey because of my life event. So your life has to motivate to that extent. So it happens. In everyone's life, that happens. But how far they are getting motivated is God's side. No one knows. So it takes time. Because their life has to motivate, not myself or my guru. Their life has to motivate them. So Ambani, if you go to the Ambani and he will say, you do heartfulness meditation, that is best for you. He asks, how much is the profit I'll get? How much profit? How many dollars? How many lakhs? How many crores I'll get through the meditation? He is asking immediately that question. If he feels the stress, he can realize the effect of heartfulness meditation immediately. So that is how life will make you to motivate. Like you to be motivated. Yeah.
That's so beautiful, sir. Like our soul is like a drop in the larger ocean, and it came for its own purpose of experiencing life. And then again going back to that infinite ocean. That's very nice, sir. With this, you can share your final message to our audience on heartfulness meditation.
Yeah. So, heartfulness is there or not? Pyramid meditation is there or not? Struggles are there or not? It doesn't matter. Are you happy and are you confident to continue in that path or not? That does matter. So your ability and your stability, that does matter finally. You have to make it. Only you have to make it. Even Master says, Sahajmarg will be offering services, but it cannot transform you on its own. You have to transform with the help of transmission. You have to transform with the help of heartfulness meditation technique. So you be happy, you be stronger, and you are the hero in your life. That's all. That is what my final message is.
That's very amazing, sir. With this, I thank you for giving this wonderful wisdom of heartfulness meditation, and also we are looking forward for the webinar of 3 days. Thank you so much.
Thank you.